Hi, I am Rohan. I will be explaining the code and working of our project Stream Data Analysis and Prediction of Weather using IoT Devices. Let me explain the project in abstract manner. What we did was we collected data from Arduino. We collected data from sensors using Arduino and simultaneously stored the data in CSV file. Using stream data analysis tool like Apache Kafka, the Kafka producer will retrieve the data from CSV file and produce it to a particular topic. The consumer will consume the data from that particular topic and simultaneously write the data to MySQL database. Using the database, we created and plotted the graph in website. Let me start from Arduino. This is the Arduino. This is the BHT11 temperature humidity sensor. This is BMP180 pressure sensor. Data pin of BHT11 is connected to digital pin 2 of Arduino. Data pin of BMP180 is connected to analog pin of 3 and 4 of Arduino Uno. Arduino is connected to laptop through this USB cable. Let me show you the code of Arduino. This is the code of Arduino. This is same simple DHT library of DHT11 sensor. This is BMP180 sensor library. DHT11 is connected to digital pin 2 of Arduino. This is specified here. There will be two functions in Arduino programming. One is setup function, second one is loop function. The loop function will run forever. The setup function will run only once. This is the initial, the output of the Arduino will be shown in the serial monitor here. The serial monitor baud rate is set here, 9600. The loop function will run forever. The data from the Arduino will be retrieved here. This will print the data to serial monitor. To get the data in CSV file, we used PuTTY software. Here we gave CSV file name and we gave specified the correct port name where the Arduino was connected, and we were able to collect the data in CSV file. Let me show you the CSV file. This is the January data CSV file, what we have collected and stored here. Other, we have data from 2001 to 2020. Other data we collected through internet. Now let us see the Java program of producer and consumer. This is the producer program. I have imported the required packages here. This is callback interface. This is Kafka producer and buffer reader and file reader for reading the data from CSV files. I have written the program such that it will create a thread which will produce the data to particular topic. Sending the data to particular topic, there are two modes of sending the data to particular topic. One is synchronous and asynchronous. Asynchronous, if we are sending the data in asynchronous manner, we have to implement the callback interface. And the callback interface implementation I have done here. This is the implementation. This is the demo callback class which implements the callback interface. This asynchronous manner of sending the data will only send one message at a time. Message key and what is the partition and what is at what time what data is sent. Only one data will be sent to the topic. But we are, for our implementation, we are sending the data in synchronous manner. So the asynchronous part will be set to false. That will be written in producer run program. And this is the run method of our producer program. If data is sent in asynchronous manner, the producer dot send function, the send function will send the data. asynchronous manner. The demo callback function will be called here. We are sending the data in synchronous manner. So the buffered reader, using buffered reader and file reader, we will fetch the data from this CSV file and we will read the data line by line and send the data to producer through this line. The data will be returned to the topic and simultaneously in the console for our reference, and finally it will show how many data are read. This is the producer run program. This will start the my producer thread. This is the topic name. Check is the topic name that I have created in the server. And Boolean asynchronous mode is set to false here. And the producer thread is the parameters for producer is sent here. And the producer is start, thread is started. This is the consumer program. I have imported the required packages here. And the Kafka broker ID, server URL is specified here. And client is named here. The topic that I have specified in the producer is specified here. And the max number of messages can be sent is 100. Means max number of message can be read at a time is 100. I have restricted there to only to demonstrate it. And this consumer program will simultaneously write the data to MySQL database also. So the MySQL database connection code is here. This consumer create function, create consumer function, will create a consumer and return the consumer. The required properties to create the consumer is set here, written here. Bootstrap servers, what is the server on which consumer will be created, the group ID of the server and client ID of the consumer, and key serializer and deserializer, and max number of records can be read is specified here, and consumer will be created and returned from this function create consumer. This is the main function. I have created a consumer by calling the create consumer method. This is the code for my connecting to MySQL server. And in this code, the data is read from specified topic and fields are separated and values are stored in temporary variables. And simultaneously in SQL query, the data is sent and updated here, and it is also shown in the console what data is read. For running the producer and consumer codes, the pre-requirement is that we have to run Apache Kafka Zookeeper server and Apache Kafka server. It should be running, and the topic should be created before only. For that, creating topic and running the servers, I have written a shell script code. Let us see the shell script code. This is the shell script code. This will open a terminal, new terminal, and start the Zookeeper server. And this code will start the Kafka server, and this code will create a topic named check here, and the topic name will be printed afterwards. Let us run the shell script code now. This is Zookeeper server starting. Zookeeper server started here. Now Kafka server is started here. and the topic is created here. Now we will run the producer program. We started producing the on the topic check, and 60 data read from that file that I have passed. Now we will run the consumer program. Consumer received the data from the topic here and waiting to receive more data, and this will be simultaneously data will be returned to the MySQL database also. To see the database, I have to start Apache server first. This is the weather database I have created. This is the table. These are the data values stored, and other data which we got from other internet websites, we imported that and stored in the database. Now let us see the website. This is the website created by me. RS means Rohan and Siddharth. This is the home page of the website. These values are not static, these are dynamic values, changes from day by day. This is the history page. You can view the data in monthly or yearly manner. Let us see February 2020 data. This is the graph will be plotted according to the selected month and year. Temperature, humidity and pressure graph will be predicted and printed here. This is the yearly tab. The data will be shown in graph of yearly data. This is 2016 temperature, humidity and pressure data. This is it. This is the website we have created. Let me show the code. This is the home page code. This is the code of humidity graph plotting. The data from the drop down list will be collected here, and for MySQL connection the code is written here, and for particular month and selection of particular month and date from the particular column, date I means this column date means. And the query will be executed and data will be stored in the variables. The code for the creation of graph is written here. This is the dimensions of the graph, 640 and 450. And the margin of the graph is set here, and the title of the graph is written here, and the color of the graph plotting line will is written here, and color is set here, and add plot will add the graph to a plot, and stroke function will draw the graph. This is it. Thank you.